Dear students, now we are going to solve important problem in parallel structure method.
Parallel structure can be obtained by using direct form 2 method. Let's discuss the steps to be followed in this parallel structure method. Here the first step is the transfer function of the system is expressed into its partial fraction. Here h of s represents the overall transfer function of the system that can be expressed in terms of partial fraction. So here each partial fraction is considered as the separate transfer function. Then we have to realize each transfer function in direct form 2 method. Finally, we have to connect all the structures in parallel to get the overall parallel structure of the system. Let's solve one problem, then you can easily understand the concept here. Here the problem is to realize the given LTI continuous time system in parallel form structure. So the system is described using differential equation here. D squared y of t by dt squared plus 3 dy of t by dt plus 2 y of t is equal to x of t. So here in the solution part, the first step is to take the Laplace transform on both the sides of the given differential equation. Then we can get Laplace transform of d squared y of t by dt squared plus 3 Laplace transform of dy of t by dt plus 2 Laplace transform of y of t is equal to Laplace transform of x of t. Okay. As we know that the Laplace transform of d squared y of t by dt squared is nothing but s squared y of s. Similarly, we can get 3s y of s plus 2 y of s is equal to x of s. Then we can take this y of s as a common term in the left hand side and then move this values to this right hand side. As we know that the transfer function of the system is nothing but the ratio of the Laplace transform of the output to the Laplace transform of the input signal. From this expression, we can get the transfer function h of s is equal to y of s divided by x of s is equal to 1 divided by s squared plus 3s plus 2. So now we have obtained the transfer function of the system. After getting the transfer function, we are going to represent the transfer function in its partial fraction method. So here h of s is equal to 1 by s squared plus 3s plus 2. That can be written as 1 divided by s plus 1 into s plus 2. So the roots for this denominator is s plus 1 and s plus 2. So this can be written as a by s plus 1 plus b by s plus 2. Then we have to find out the values of a and b. So here, in order to find out the value of a, we have to take this fraction as such, 1 divided by s plus 1, s plus 2, multiplied with s plus 1, where s is equal to minus 1. Then we can get, cancel this 2, and then 1 divided by s is equal to minus 1, plus 2 is equal to 1. So a is equal to 1. Similarly, we can obtain the value of b. So here b is minus 1. So after getting the values of a and b, substitute those values in the equation. Then we can get h of s is equal to 1 divided by s plus 1. So here a is nothing but 1 plus b is nothing but minus 1. So minus 1 divided by s plus 2. Then we can consider each partial fraction as a separate transfer function. So here we can represent h1 of s is equal to 1 divided by s plus 1, h2 of s is equal to minus 1 divided by s plus 2. So after getting this partial fraction, we are going to draw the direct form 2 for each transfer function separately. Let's start with the first transfer function h1 of s. H1 of s is equal to 1 divided by s plus 1. So here we can write h1 of s is nothing but y1 of s by x1 of s, that is equal to, in direct form 2 method, the first step is to divide all the terms with the highest power of s. So here highest power of s is s itself. So we are going to divide all the terms in the numerator as well as in the denominator with s. So here 1 by s divided by s by s is nothing but 1 plus 1 by s. Okay. After that, we have to separate the transfer function into two parts. Here y1 of s by w1 of s multiplied with w1 of s by x1 of s. Simply we are multiplying the numerator and denominator with the value w1 of s. Okay, so we can make the two terms like this. That is equal to, we can write the numerator as 1 by s multiplied with the denominator like this. 1 divided by 1 plus 1 by s. So then we can equate the values here. Y1 of s by W1 of s is equal to the numerator value. Here the numerator is 1 by s. From this we can get cross multiply these terms. Okay, so you can get s into y1 of s. Actually we want to get only the y of s. That is the actual output. So we are keeping that value as such and move this w1 of s to this right hand side. So we can get y1 of s, that is the output for the first subsystem. We can say that as a subsystem, or the first transfer function is equal to w1 of s by s. So next equate this term. W1 of s by x1 of s is equal to 1 divided by 1 plus 1 by s. So we can get W1 of s by x1 of s is equal to 1 divided by 1 plus 1 by s. Then we can cross multiply this two. We can get x1 of s is equal to W1 of s plus W1 of s by s. Here it is the input signal. This is the intermediate output between x and y. So here we can get the output W1 of s is equal to x1 of s minus W1 of s by s. So now we are going to draw the direct form 2 structure for these two equations. Okay. So here we can get x1 of s is the input signal. This W1 of s is the output signal, intermediate output signal. Okay, so we have to get this W1 of s by adding these two values. So we have to give this W1 of s to this 1 by s block. Then we can get W1 of s by s here. That is multiplied with minus 1. So here it is minus 1. Then we can add these two. We can get the value W1 of s. So what is the value of y1 of s? That is the actual output. Y1 of s is equal to W1 of s by yes. So we are taking the output directly from this point. So this is what the y1 of s. So this is the direct form 2 for the first transfer function. So the same way we can obtain the direct form 2 structure for the second transfer function. Here the second transfer function is h2 of s is equal to minus 1 divided by s plus 2, correct? So that is equal to, again we have to divide all the terms with the power of highest power of s. Here the highest power of s is s itself. So here minus 1 by s divided by 1 plus 2 by s. The same way we can make the transfer function into two terms, y2 of s by w2 of s, w2 of s by x2 of s. Then we can equate the terms. Here the w2 of s by y2 of s by w2 of s is nothing but the numerator value minus 1 by s. Next, this w2 of s by x2 of s is nothing but the denominator 1 by the denominator value here. Equate both the terms. We can obtain the equations like this. So y2 of s by w2 of s is equal to minus 1 by s. Then y2 of s is equal to minus w of s. So here we can move this term to this right hand side. So minus w of s by s, then w2 of s by x2 of s is equal to this denominator value, right? 1 divided by 1 plus 2 by s. So we can cross multiply these things. We can get x2 of s is equal to w2 of s plus 2w2 of s by s. So here this is the input for the second transfer function. This is the intermediate output. So we have to get this intermediate output like this. W2 of s is equal to, shift this signal to this side with a minus sign. Then we can get the direct form 2 structure for this second transfer function. Here x2 of s is the second input signal. This is what dw2 of s, that is equal to x2 of s minus 2w2 of s by s. So here we have to give this w2 of s. This is the actually w2 of s that is given to this 1 by s block. At this point we can get w2 of s by s, that is multiplied with minus 2. Okay. So here we can get w2 of s. What is the output y2 of s? That is minus w of s by s. So we have to take this w2 of s by s here and multiply this value with minus 1 and then get the value y2 of s. Okay. Finally, the parallel structure can be obtained by combining these two h1 of s and h2 of s in parallel format. So parallel means the inputs are common. So here we can take x of s as a common input for both the transfer functions, and we have to obtain the output signal by adding the outputs of these two transfer functions. Do you all understand? This is what the h1 of s, this is h2 of s. Finally, we can connect these two transfer functions in parallel format. Parallel means the inputs are common, correct? So here x of s is common for both the terms, right? And then get the output by adding the outputs of each transfer function. So this is the parallel structure for the given system.